attitude check.
Awesome.
All right, so for those visiting, that's an old Camp Count trick. So I love doing it, and it's really cool hearing it in stereo. That's fantastic. So I want to welcome everybody this morning. I see some visitors and some new faces. I see other folks that we haven't seen for a while. I'm just thrilled to have you here with us. We still have some people coming in, which is great. And I know they were still doing shots, flu shots over in the... That was awful. Doing flu shots in the kitchen. Pray for me, I'll take care of that. You know, right before I came up, he said, it's the only church you can go to and get shot. And that's, anyway, all right, let's start over. Brad is still giving flu shots in the kitchen. It can only get better. Anyway, so as folks are still coming in, I've already mentioned I see some visitors and folks with us this morning. That's awesome. So one thing that I'd like to point out, that's new, just to show we're always trying new things and progressing and changing. If you notice, your bulletin this morning looks just a little different. It's a little bigger. And the reason is, since I was so confused every week about what color the visitors' cards were, we put them in the bulletin. And they're perforated. Whoops. So if you'll fill that out, if you are a visitor, or if you have a prayer need, you can fill that out right on your bulletin, tear that out, and stick it in the offering. So, something new and cool. Yes?
Anybody else
need their flu shot that has signed up?
If you're signed up, you haven't gotten there yet, come on in.
Yeah, don't worry about getting up and going in and back. That's no sweat. Just go get it taken care of. We're thrilled to do that. On October 9th, so that's this coming Saturday, we'll be doing the Missions of the Missionary for the kids. That's going to be kindergarten through fifth grade. It's going to be a good time. And I know we had the sign-up sheet and the recipe stuff out there, so it's still out there. If you want to volunteer to do something, I'm sure Diana would love all the help she can get. Mission ministry, there should have been the quarterly offering for this quarter's, actually this the last quarter, but that mission offering envelope should have been in your bulletin this morning. And that is for, I'm looking for, it's the world mission offering, sorry about that. So if you guys are compelled to give to that, put your gift in that envelope and you can drop that in the offering plate at any time over the next couple of weeks. We appreciate that. There will be a brief meeting, this is important, after Bible study this Wednesday. Regardless, you know, we took this week off just to give. There were a lot of people that had exposure to COVID or second re-exposure, just lots of nervousness this week, so we took a little break just to let that all die down. So I assume that we'll be on schedule this week, but regardless, there will be a meeting for all Sunday school teachers, as well as anybody that's interested in becoming or doing Sunday school as a teacher, adult, youth, or children, okay? And that'll be at 7 o'clock right after Bible study. You're welcome to come and help out with that. The directories are available. If you didn't see them on the Welcome Center when you came in, there's a big basket right there. So take one of those and look it over. We're excited to be able to get those, and there's a special thanks there for Katie for doing the pictures. I thought they all looked great, so hopefully everybody's satisfied. If not, good talk to Katie. She's a big girl, she can take care of herself. Now, we appreciate her help with that. A couple things that aren't in your bulletin this morning that I would like to mention. The decoration committee, they've been doing a nice job. I really appreciate them working together and getting things transitioned over to fall. I think the sanctuary looks really nice. So we're appreciative of that. Also, in some of the things that they're doing, they're just kind of cleaning things up for me. Yes, we have the bulletins and the directories on the Welcome Center today, but in an attempt to keep that cleaned off so that we can actually use it to greet people and engage with you, all of the other information for the short term is going to be on the side table over here in the marketplace. It has a nice sign over it that says information. So when we talk about signups or this thing or that thing, it's going to be on this table over here. Okay? So I just wanted to point that out. In addition to that, a couple of things that we have going on that I think you'd like to know about, short to longer term. You know, we have a committee meeting. I call them ad hoc committees, but that's just a name for a temporary committee. Working on the whole experience of what someone sees when they come into church and even as a visitor. Their whole experience from the time they come up to come in, where they get to Sunday school, where they need to get to church, how they're treated here, how we follow up with them. And so they're working on that as well as just how everything looks. And working with the decoration committee to a degree also. So you're going to see some things happening there. I just want to let you know that's going on. It's a big team, so they're not working in a vacuum. You're all very well represented. But if you have any ideas or information, you can let Carrie know about that. She's heading it up. Just let her know if you have some ideas. Also, the kids and the youth. You may have noticed if you have children in our children's program, when you go down the hall, there's now a table. There's a sign to welcome them. And I'm going to take a phrase or repurpose a phrase that we've used in the past for the building. We call that secure the future, right? I'm going to reuse that phrase for our kids and call it secure the future. When we benchmark other churches and what they're doing, they have a very good program to keep the kids isolated and safe from all kinds of different things, but mainly just that they're together. We know where they're at. We know who's dropping them off. And we know who's picking them up. And so we're taking some steps incrementally to do some of the things that we benchmarked from other churches. And so you'll start to notice some changes back there. The first thing is we've moved the youth out of the room up here back to the back hallway. So as of this morning, all the kids and youth are in the same hallway. All the adult classes are up here. That's intentional, okay? And it's all about securing the future, all right? So just wanted to let you know about that. The last thing I have for you is just a reminder that it is Communion Sunday, so we're doing our benevolence retiring offering this morning. So with that, that's a lot. I've got one waving.
Yeah.
Okay. We talked last week about the CPR class coming up. We were going to get some scheduling information and a sign up. I don't know if we have an update for you or not. I'm looking.
No. We'll have a sign up next week.
Okay. So the rule says we'll have that information next week. All right. So keep that in the back of your mind that that opportunity is coming up, and keep an eye out for that. All right. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, I thank you so much for long announcements. It's just proof, God, that we're saying yes. It's proof that we're listening and we're doing and we're acting. And I'm just thrilled to be part of a church family, Lord, that is doing what you're asking of them. And Lord, I'm grateful for the blessings that we're seeing in new faces and growth and seeing people coming closer to you. Lord, as we're gathered in this hour to stop and to focus on you, I pray that you will be with us, that you will open our hearts and open our ears, that we can hear you, that we can feel your presence, and we'll continue to move, to work for your mission. Lord, bless this hour, bless everything that we do, that it will glorify you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Good morning. Good morning. Will you please stand and join me in singing our opening hymn, "This Is My Father's World"?
This is my Father's world, and to my
can store my batteries. Thank you for coming. This is a very, very special Sunday. And most people probably wouldn't realize it, but today is World Communion Sunday. And in a little bit, we'll be sharing the supper of the Lord. And sometimes we forget that there are historical reasons for these things. World Communion Sunday was first celebrated in 1933 in a Presbyterian church, but it wasn't adopted by the Christian community until 1940. And it just reminds us that we are all in the body of believers. I don't know about you, but I like unity. Unity is important. We don't celebrate unity enough. And I remember in Huntington, when I was there, we would come to the middle of an intersection, five churches, and we'd all gather there for communion on World Communion Sunday. Now that was really great. It was a really good feeling, except one Sunday, they forgot to tell the fire department. And they had a triple assignment with a snorkel and three pumpers and an officer. And they come flying down the street, and the officer, and I had a radio with me, said, "There's some kind of altar in the middle of the street." And the chief said, "Run the sidewalk." So all these fire trucks were going down the sidewalk. I've never seen such chaos and mess in my life. That was a communion that was a hot mess. But we got through it, and everybody seemed to appreciate how chaos can be brought about into order. So maybe that's what our theme today is. It's not just unity, but it's dealing with chaos. And I think there's a lot of chaos in the world right now. And we need some unity. And we need to make sure that things are done according to God's plan. Today, as we come to the Lord in prayer, let me remind you that God loves you. He's here looking at you. He's here sharing with you. And you need to share with Him. It's a two-way street. And sometimes in prayer, we forget it's a two-way street. So today, please take a moment and talk to God. But most importantly, during this hour, make sure that you're listening to Him. Let's go to the Lord. Father, there's a lot of things on our heart and our mind today, and we just ask a very special blessing. We just ask that during this time of prayer and during this time of worship, that we'll feel Your presence and know Your truth. We just pray that during this time, as You love us and You care for us, that indeed this is a special day. It's Your day. It's the day that You have made. Now come and walk among us as we hear Your word, but as we strive to do Your will. Bless us now. And may this be a day of remembering, but also may it be a day of unity. Because all around the world there are people that just have trouble getting along. They name the name of Christ, but they still have trouble being Christian. And we just pray today that indeed You'll come and bless us. And You'll help us to understand how good You are and how good You want us to be. This is Your day. And we want to be Your people. Now come and walk among us as we expose our hearts, as we open our minds, as we listen to Your Spirit, that in and through all things we might praise You. But also, in and through all things, may we be changed. May we be different in a few moments as we leave here than we were when we got here. That indeed our lives might be enriched and we might be led in a new direction. Bless us now that we might be a blessing to others. This is not about giving or getting. It's about giving to You and receiving a blessing in this world. Father, this world right now needs Your blessing. Father, look kindly upon those that are listed in our service folder, those that are suffering from illness, that are suffering from diseases, that are suffering from the pandemic, and also those that are suffering spiritually. Sometimes we forget they need a special blessing. Lord, come among them now. Help us, heal us. Those that are lonely, lost, and looking for a loving Savior. For this is your day, and we want to be your people. In Christ's name, I ask these things. Amen. As we receive our offering this morning, I remind you that this is the gift you give God for the work of his people. And the work goes on, and we appreciate your support and what you do. Our ushers will now wait upon us. Thank you for this day, that we can use it, magnify your word and your work. Now, bless gift and giver now. In Christ's name I pray. Amen. As we prepare for the supper of our Lord, if you fail to pick up your communion elements, if you just slip your hand up, I know you've forgotten yours. You've gone over here. You better be good to him to give you a shot. Someone was telling me today that this new adoration of the Lord's Supper, the new way we're doing this, that the unleavened bread reminded them of chiclets. No, it's certified unleavened bread. It's not a chiclet, okay? But this is a better way of doing it. It's a little more, I was going to use the word sanitary, but it really is very well sealed. And we hope that as we try these different applications, that we'll find one that you like. So please make sure you have these elements. Our deacons will now come and share the service of the table. I'd remind you, the night in which our Lord Jesus Christ was betrayed, he took bread and when he had given thanks, he said, "This is my body, which is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me." We'll now have prayer for the bread of the broken body of Christ.
Our Lord and Father, we thank you for this day. We thank you, Lord, for the sacrifice that was made to grant us eternal life, to spend eternity with you. Your love is more than we ever expect. Thank you for this. In Jesus' holy name. Amen.
Jesus took bread, and when he had given thanks, he said, "This is my body, which is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup, and he reminded them that this was not a cup of refreshment. This was a cup of blessing. And so as we pray for the cup of sacrifice, let us give thanks for this blessing. Let us pray.
And above all, thank you for saying it's just enjoy the diversity so we can have enjoy what we have with you. I pray that you be with us here with your blessing, and that will be the presence of all our studies. Amen.
The cup reminds us of the blood of Jesus and that his sacrifice for us. Do this also in remembrance of him. Scriptures tell us that after they shared this supper, they sang a hymn, "Blessed be the tie that binds," will be our hymn today.
Blessed be the tie that binds our hearts in Christian love. A fellowship of kindred bonds is like to that alone.
Amen. You know, we call upon our pastors to do a lot of different things. And being the mentoring pastor here, I get to work with these two guys, and it's kind of interesting that they do all kinds of things very, very well. And sometimes we need to remind them and express our appreciation to them. So now that we have a youth pastor, he has another role. He's also my bodyguard. You mess with him, you deal with the guy, okay? But we appreciate his talents, but we also appreciate our pastor who does so many things well. And when he shares those special music, don't forget to thank him for that. It's not entertainment. It's a praise and a glory to God. Troy.
Thank you.
it's really good to have a multi-talented staff. And he not only plays the piano, but you play the drums. I play the radio. I do it very well, by the way. But, you know, we like to use our talents, too. And we do that so that we inspire you to use your talents. And I know some people in this room have great talents, but they don't use them for the Lord. So we would invite you, if you get tired of hearing Troy, and you really don't want to hear of someone beat on the drum, and you're tired of the radio, come and talk to us, because God's good, and He wants your talents to praise Him. Today we're looking at the Book of Beginnings, and that's the official Hebrew name of Genesis. And we're going to be looking at just the first three verses. But I think it's important every year or so just to stop and go back to the front of the Bible and go back to the beginnings, to go back to the original thoughts that go on. I've been privileged to study and travel in Israel, and I remember seeing a lot of the copies of the codices of the different versions of Scripture and the different writings of the epics of creation. But it's interesting, they all parallel one another. And it doesn't make any difference if you're Assyrian or Babylonian or Egyptian. You come to the whole narrative of Genesis. And I don't know about you, I need to be reminded every once in a while that I didn't create this world, and the world doesn't, pass on me. It's all about God. I need to be reminded that He's the Creator, He's the God, He's the one in charge. Even when I don't feel He's in charge, He's in charge. And we need to remember that. And I hope this was just one of many reminders about who God is and what He's done. Let's hear then those first three verses of the first chapter of Genesis. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. The earth was without form and void, and darkness was on the face of the deep. And the Spirit of God was hovering over the face of the waters. Then God said, "Let there be light." And there was light. Father God, bless the words of my mouth and meditations of all our hearts, and may they be acceptable in my sight. O Lord, our blessed Redeemer. In Christ's name, amen. Only Genesis tells us the story in the eyes of the Creator of the creation. And I really believe that too many times we get confused. We think we're in charge. We think that somehow the world revolves around us. Do you know anybody like that? Do you know anybody that thinks you're the most important thing in the world? Oh, I think somewhere deep inside of us, we all do that. Somehow the world revolves around us. Let me just stop just for a moment and be reminded of Genesis, that it's the Spirit of God that made all things, and He made them right and made them good. And it's important that we talk about that. And only Genesis tells us the story of the law of God as the creation God. He is a God that reveals Himself. He's the only God that reveals Himself. Does He reveal Himself totally? No, He doesn't. He only reveals to us what He wants us to know about Him. And that's very important to understand. Many people talk about the God of love. But we need to remember where that came from. And we need also to remember that God created everything out of chaos. There was chaos. And God ordered it, and God saw that it was good. And when we talk about chaos, it's time that we remember that God made sense out of a chaotic universe. Now, I don't know about you, but, as I read through these different epics, I like the way people try to make God more of a person when He's really God. And also, when you read through the epics, especially in the ancient text, they give chaos a name, and that name was Tiamat. and he was a monster. The monster of Tiamat would bring chaos and creation, and God came and he saved the monster Tiamat and created the world. It's kind of interesting to deal with that because I think there's a lot of monsters in our world today. And then chaos likes to take a name and order himself. And so God comes along and he establishes order. Now, I don't know about you, I like order. I like things to be orderly. I even go in my closet and line up my wife's shoes. And I line up my shoes. I just, shoes go in a certain order. You know, and shirts go in a certain place. And slacks go in a certain, and then there's the one thing that I can never get straight, and that's the sock drawer. There's always one extra sock. I don't know where it comes from. You know, you do your laundry, and I think maybe those socks get together and have a baby or something. There's always an extra sock. And it's kind of interesting to deal with that, because that's some of the little chaos of the big chaos of our life. I go and visit people in the hospital, and they start talking about their illnesses and how they feel. And so many times when you're ill, it's an internal chaos, and it needs to be resolved. And God comes along and sits bright, and it's important. There's another part of that chaos we need to remember. It seems to me that the world is getting to be a dark place, a darker place. This was the first time I can remember when we really started talking about the chaos of the world. And I don't mean politically, although that's part of it, but every institution that we deal with, we're dealing with chaos. The chaos of education, the chaos of healthcare, the chaos of our government, the chaos of our own lives. There's chaos everywhere. I remember when this whole pandemic thing started, my wife and I were talking, and that maybe sounds okay to you, but my wife and I don't talk a lot. Well, she read the Bible. And if you start in Genesis, go to Revelation, all the good relationships are there, and we need to celebrate. And too many times, we get overcome by the chaos of our lives. Too many times, we forget about our human relationships. And too many times in our relationships, we forget about God. I'm so thankful that I'm reminded daily of how much God loves me and how much he takes care of things and how much we have to be thankful for. And remind us also that God is a self-revealing God. Now, we're not going to know all the things about God. He's not going to reveal himself totally to us, but he's going to reveal enough of himself that we can rely on him and understand that he loves us and wants to care for us. And it's good to know that he's going to tell us what we need to know when we need to know it. And I've learned that we have to trust God. I've learned that we have to love him and he loves us. That's part of what it means to be self-revealing. Also, when he reveals himself, we learn to trust him. Think of some of the messes that you've been through in your life. I've been through some real messy things. And when I've learned to lean on God and trust him, he kind of always brings an answer to that. And he always brings a reassurance. I think today is a day of reassurance. Today is a day of knowing who God is. Today is a day of revealing that God loves us and cares for us, whether it's in Genesis or all the way through Revelation. But the end of those verses, then God said, let there be light. And there was light. I don't know about you, but I'm affirmed because of that. Isn't it good to know that after darkness, there's light? Isn't it good to know that God wants us to see and do and be a part of good things and light things? Isn't it good to know that God wants us to know that not only he's self-revealing, but he's also a loving God? I'm glad to know when everything fails, I can trust God. Amen. And I'm glad to know that he loves me. And he cares for me in the worst times of my life. We need to know him. And to know him is to love him. How do we know him? How do we get to really know who God is? By trusting in Jesus Christ. Jesus is the Son of God, and he wants us to know what God's like. So he reveals himself to us as he comes into our hearts and as he saves us. I was thinking the other day, it must be a very lonely place to live in this world and not be saved. It must be a fearful place to know that maybe this is all there is. Well, it can't be. It's going to get better, and it's getting better all the time. I believe that, and I want to live it. I want to challenge you today to believe it and live it away as well. Genesis is all about God, but also Genesis is all about love and trust. Do you love him? Do you trust him? That's what Genesis is about. That's the light that verse 3 talks about. Let there be light. Let there be trust. Let there be love. That's what the church is about. And that's what I challenge you today on this World Communion Sunday. Let there be light. Light in the dark places of your life. And I think all of us have some dark places. And God needs to burst through those dark places. There's a concept we use in counseling. And it's called the Joe Harry window. And it's kind of a neat thing. You take it, you draw a window pane, and there's four sections to it. And the first section is that section that you know about yourself. And the second section is that these are things that everybody else knows about you. And the last part of it is these are things that you don't even know about yourself. I know there's probably some dark places in my life, but God knows. He still loves me. He forgives me. He guides me. He brings light. I'm going to challenge you today to bring light to your life. Look at your living and know there's some dark places. Turn them over to Jesus. You know, Jesus loves you, and he's going to take care of you. And that's so very important. This truly is God's day. Now, I don't know what you're going to do today, but I'm going to take time to spend a little bit of time with my family, a little bit of time and some lunch. I always have, on Sunday, I have the sacred nap hour. Very important. I have to have a nap. But I'm going to appreciate the Lord. God has given us so much, and he's given you the love and light. But you've got to trust him. Who do you trust today? Who are you leaning upon? Is there a place in your life that you need light? Well, I will tell you today, let there be light. Amen? Father God, bless conclusion of our service today. May your grace be upon us. And if there's someone here today looking for light and love and direction, may they realize they don't find it in an institution, they don't find it in any other than Jesus Christ. Thank you for this day. Move among us now. If there's someone looking for a church home, if there's someone that needs to make a decision, Pastor Troy will be here to greet them. This is a special day because it's your day, and we need to know you love us. My Jesus, I love thee because you first loved us. Be in any decision that we make this day, in Christ's name. Amen.
Our closing hymn, we do have hymnals on page 79. It's Jesus, I Love You. Why those other words don't need it.
Thank you.
interesting morning. And I think, as Dr. Carrico alluded, sometimes these things and groomings just remind me that God is in control. And no matter what our plans are for the week and how we think we're going to bring God's message to you, God's going to do it how He wants to do it. And I just praise Him for however that happens. Lightning, power surges, misspeaking, making crazy jokes by accident. But listen, at the end of the day, we just spend an hour focused on God. We just spend an hour taking in the light of God. And our opportunity as we leave this place today is to reflect that light and to take that light with us into a world of darkness that needs to see it. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this time and thank you for the opportunity to be together as a church family fellowship, to praise you, to spend an hour basking in your light. Lord, just remind us we can be in that light, we can be in that presence anytime. We just need to stop. We need to focus on you. We need to ask for your presence. We need to just pray and commune with you. And we can feel that light. We can feel that love. We can feel your grace at any time. Lord, be with us as we go on our way this week. Let us be a reflection of you, always mindful of our witness, and take every opportunity to share with somebody the awesomeness, the wonderful and incredible things that you're doing in our lives every day. We thank you and we praise you, Lord, and we give you all the glory. And all of God's people said, amen. Thank you. Right now? Okay, so there's a couple extra doses. If you still need a flu shot, go to the kitchen.